The tale of the silent Buddha's encounter with the Lord of Death. In the ancient city of Benares, nestled in the north of India, lived a remarkably affluent man. Following his father's death, he found himself heir to an even larger fortune. Reflecting on his riches, he questioned, "Why keep this wealth solely for myself? Let others also benefit from its abundance." Thus he constructed dining halls at the four entrances of the city, north, east, south, and west. Within these halls, he generously provided food to all who sought it. His reputation for generousness spread far and wide. Moreover, word spread that he and his followers were adherents of the five training steps: refraining from killing, stealing, sexual misconduct, lying, and taking intoxicants. In those days, a silent Buddha was found meditating in the forest near Benares. He earned the title Buddha due to his enlightenment, signifying that he no longer perceived himself, the entity referred to as I or me, as distinct from all other living beings. Thus he attained the ability to perceive life in its true essence, fully immersed in every moment of the present. Being one with all life, he harbored deep compassion and empathy for the suffering of all beings. Driven by his desire to share enlightenment and alleviate their distress, he longed to guide them towards the same state of awakening he had attained. However, the era depicted in our tale was fraught with sorrow and misfortune, a period marked by a profound inability, among others, to grasp the truth and perceive life's true nature. Aware of this prevailing condition, the silent Buddha chose to remain silent, understanding the futility of verbal teachings in such a time. Immersed in meditation within the forest, the silent Buddha reached an exceptionally elevated mental state. His concentration was so profound that he maintained a single posture for 7 consecutive days and nights, abstaining from both food and drink. Upon emerging from his heightened state, the silent Buddha was in danger of dying from starvation. As was customary, he ventured to the mansion of the affluent individual in Benares to seek alms food at the usual hour of the day. As the rich man settled down for his midday meal, he caught sight of the silent Buddha approaching with his alms bowl. Reverence swelling within him, he promptly rose from his seat out of respect. Instructing his servant to go forth and offer alms to the silent Buddha, he demonstrated profound admiration for the enlightened being. In the shadows, Mara, the deity of death, observed the unfolding scene keenly. Mara, driven by insatiable greed for dominion over all beings, thrived on the pervasive fear of mortality that gripped them. A Buddha, being fully immersed in each moment of existence, harbors no longing for future life, nor fear of death. Consequently, Mara, realizing his inability to exert power over the silent Buddha, harbored a burning desire to destroy him. Recognizing the silent Buddha's vulnerable state nearing death due to starvation, Mara perceived a prime opportunity to achieve his sinister objective. Before the servant could offer food into the silent Buddha's alms bowl, Mara intervened, conjuring forth a deep pit filled with scorching, red-hot burning coals, resembling the very gateway to a realm of infernal torment. Upon beholding the terrifying sight, the servant was seized with an overwhelming dread that rendered him paralyzed with fear. Hastily, he fled back to his master, trembling with fright. In response to the rich man's inquiry about why he had returned without giving the alms food, the servant mumbled, "My lord, a deep pit filled with searing, red-hot burning coals obstructs the path before the silent Buddha." The rich man, initially skeptical of the servant's account, concluded that perhaps the man was delusional. Determined to test the situation, he dispatched another servant with alms food. However, this servant too was struck with terror upon encountering the same pit of blazing coals. Despite sending several more servants in succession, Each one returned in a state of utter fear, unable to approach the silent Buddha. The master, discerning the inexplicable terror gripping his servants, concluded that Mara, the god of death, must be orchestrating this obstruction to thwart his virtuous act of offering alms to the silent Buddha. Understanding that wholesome deeds mark the outset of the journey towards enlightenment, he realized that Mara sought to impede him by any means necessary. Undeterred by Mara's machinations, the master remained steadfast in his faith in the silent Buddha and resolute in his determination to fulfill his charitable intentions. Undeterred by the harrowing sight, the master resolved to deliver the alms food to the silent Buddha personally. As he approached, he too witnessed the ominous flames emanating from the fiery pit. Casting his gaze upward, he beheld the formidable figure of the god of death, looming ominously in the sky above. Gathering his courage, he inquired, "Who are you?" To which Mara, with a malevolent grin, responded, "I am the god of death." "Did you create this pit of fire?" questioned the man, his voice steady despite the dread creeping into his heart. "I did," affirmed the god of death. "And why did you do so?" pressed the man, his resolve unwavering. "To obstruct your act of offering alms food and thereby bring about the demise of the silent Buddha," declared Mara. "Furthermore, to prevent the beneficial effects of your virtuous deed on your journey towards enlightenment, ensuring you remain ensnared within my grasp." The rich man of Benares confronted Mara with unyielding resolve. "O Mara, god of death, embodiment of evil, you may attempt to extinguish the silent Buddha and obstruct my virtuous giving, but your efforts are futile. Let us put our determination to the test and witness whose resolve prevails." Gazing across the chasm of fiery turmoil, the rich man addressed the serene and enlightened silent Buddha with reverence. "O silent Buddha, may the radiance of truth endure as a beacon for us all. Please accept this offering of sustenance, a symbol of life and compassion." The rich man relinquished all sense of self, transcending any fear of death. Stepping forward into the raging inferno, he was enveloped by a beautiful cool lotus blossom, lifting him gently upward. As the miraculous flower blossomed, its golden pollen scattered into the air, adorning him with the glowing color of gold. Positioned within the heart of the lotus, the noble being poured the alms food into the bowl of the silent Buddha. In this triumph of compassion and selflessness, Mara, the god of death, met defeat. Grateful for the remarkable gesture, the silent Buddha extended his hand in blessing. In reverence, the rich man bowed deeply, joining his hands above his head in homage. With his mission fulfilled, the silent Buddha bid farewell to Benares, departing for the serene forests of the Himalayas. Remaining upon the magnificent lotus, glowing with the color of gold, the benevolent master imparted wisdom to his followers. He emphasized the importance of adhering to the five training steps to cleanse and purify the mind. "With a pure mind," he explained, "the act of giving alms holds immense merit, symbolizing the gift of life itself." Upon concluding his teachings, the fiery pit and the enchanting cool lotus vanished entirely, leaving behind only the profound wisdom imparted by the generous master. In the face of adversity, selfless acts of compassion and unwavering resolve prevail over fear and malevolent forces. Generosity, coupled with courage and purity of heart, not only benefits others but also leads to personal enlightenment and spiritual growth. By overcoming obstacles with steadfast determination, one can transcend the influence of darkness and pave the path towards peace and enlightenment.